Did you ever purchase merchandise and forget to change the purchase cost to the new purchase cost when you were recording the vendor's bill or the check? If that's the case, then you need to understand the effect of retroactive purchase cost changes. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. Retroactive purchase cost changes have an effect on your cost of goods sold and your merchandise inventory as well as your profit. And you need to understand the effect. We know that purchasing inventory at a new cost will change the average cost per unit. If we sell an item after purchasing with a new cost, the new average cost will be used to find the cost of goods sold for the sale or any future sales. However, if we change a past purchase to a new unit cost, QuickBooks will recalculate every subsequent sales cost of goods sold amount from that moment going forward. So this is what inventory looks like now. It was the check that you paid when you bought apples from Sam on May 2nd that changed the average cost of apples from $10 to $10.54. But what if in the past you made a mistake? What if you forgot to change the June 8th purchase cost on the bill for apples that you received when you received the apples back on June 8th? What would happen? Well, in that case, June 13th's sale or the cost of goods sold amount for the following sale would be different, because the average cost should have changed on June 8th. So therefore, the sale that you made on June 13th would have a different cost of goods sold. Let's take a look. Let's imagine on the June 8th bill, you accidentally forgot to change the cost each to $12.50. So let's go ahead and change it to $12.50 and see what happens to the average cost going forward. So here we are on the inventory valuation detail, and here we are at the June 8th bill. That's when you double click, it says we bought these items for $10 each. Let's change this to $12.50 because it should have been $12.50. Do you want to update apples with the new cost? Click yes. Now, if you chose yes, the new amount of this bill is $812.50. Save and close. Are you sure you want to change this because it's linked to others? Yes. Okay, not in balance. You just have to make sure that the new amount that calculates on the bottom is equal to the amount due in total on the top. That's with any transaction in QuickBooks. So we click save and close and click yes, we want to change it. Aha! Notice, starting from June 8th, the new cost per apple or average cost per apple is $10.55. And that means on the sale and on the inventory adjustment for the two transactions going forward, the cost of goods sold, the cost of goods sold and the cost of each apple were $10.55 each. Do you see that? So if I double click the invoice on June 13th, the sale amount and the income amount would be the same. But if I click reports and I click transaction journal, you will see that $7.50 of income is still the same, but you will then notice that the cost of goods sold for that sale has changed from $150 to $158 because it's taking the new average cost from what it calculated from the prior purchase. So you have to keep that in mind. And notice that not only did it change the subsequent cost, but as of the next purchase where the cost changes, it even changed that amount, because then the calculation for the average cost in weighted average would be different because the prior amounts were different. So every time there's a change in purchase cost, you can actually see the date of the new purchase cost change, because it will be the moment that the inventory valuation detail shows you a newly calculated average cost per unit.